Hi guys, hi girls, welcome to my channel. Here as always we discuss all things NFT, especially those that may relate to artists and who want to sell their work as NFT. Today's video will be devoted to one of the most popular NFT related questions that you can be asked by somebody who doesn't know anything about NFT or just heard about that and interested. They might ask you all kinds of questions like what is the point of NFT, who buys NFT, what kind of artwork can be sold as NFT, what are the risks when you become an NFT artist. Recently I was doing stories in my Instagram account answering all these questions one by one. They are still in the highlights, so you can go and check that. In this video I'm gonna address one particular question: who buys NFTs? Basically, those interested in buying NFTs fall into one of two categories: investors or collectors. There is a key difference between these two groups. Investors are more likely to see digital tokens as a short-term asset, something that looks fun and potentially profitable for now. They may later as well switch to something else. They would normally flip the NFT they bought as soon as there is some gain in that. Or even if they hold, they are probably waiting for the project they invested in to grow and become bigger, and then they will receive like multiple X profit. Anyway, investment in NFTs is considered to be one of the riskiest investments in crypto, because nobody knows what will be the value of the particular NFT in future. But the gain actually also can be huge if the value skyrockets. There were such cases already. Actually, due to them, NFTs look very attractive to some investors anyway. Collectors, we can also call them crypto enthusiasts, are more likely to see value in NFTs, artistic value, or some sentimental value, and they tend to hold their NFTs for longer term. Basically, the difference between investor and collectors is that collectors are more focused on financial support of the artists they like, and they are often crypto or NFT enthusiasts, meaning that they believe that NFTs is just the beginning of something bigger. Normally, the narrative here is that the community, the current NFT community, is building Web3, which is closely connected to NFTs and metaverses. Also, buying NFTs usually gives a collector some bragging rights, like possibility to display NFTs in some virtual exhibition or real life exhibitions, put the NFT on their avatar if it's a popular project. It's very cool to have CryptoPunk or Bored Ape as your avatar. And if you own it, this is proof by blockchain and everybody can access this information and check. A subtype of collectors I would like to highlight a bit are artists. Of course, they fall into collectors category. Many NFT artists, especially those who sell a lot, naturally believe in the community and in the technology overall. They see current NFT community as a founding community of this medium, and they believe in pushing talent and helping each other. That's why there are many artists collecting other artists, just because they want to give back to the community. So we talked about these two types of collectors: investors and collectors, and also separately about artists. And there is another group that potentially would collect NFTs, and these are everybody else. It might not that be a mainstream right now, of course, but all this buzz with metaverse and big brands that now integrate with NFT technology and sell their goods as NFT tokens is something that gives us a hint what can happen in future. Brands like Marvel and Nike launched their NFT products, and they are aimed at more traditional collectors rather than crypto enthusiasts. So we will see where it brings us with all this metaverse buzz. So now I will show you an example of a great NFT collector. He has adorable collection. It can be interesting to take a look at what he collects and how his collection looks like.
So let's take a look at punk number 6529, an example of one of the crypto enthusiast collectors. He's a lucky owner of one of crypto punks, as we can see by his avatar and name. So he named after the punk. So what we can find out here on his Twitter, he has a good following. He posts a lot about Metaverse, Web3, he onboards other collectors to collect NFTs and stuff like that. And let's see what his collection look like. So he has his OpenSea Museum collection, which is again called after the number of his punk. And here we see that he collected 1,300 works already. And these are all different kinds of NFTs. We can see photography here, some cards, some animation, and the price range varies a lot. Some NFTs bought for 0.025 and some NFTs are bought for like 3 Ethereum, 5 Ethereum. He also has virtual exhibitions on Signbird. This is the website where anyone can create their virtual collection and show it in 3D. So this is one of his collections. It's called GM collection. So it's everything about this GM, which stands for good morning and very popular salutation in crypto community. The other one is about photography. So this is all photography NFTs. I can walk here for quite some time to look around and see what's there. This is pretty much interesting exhibition by itself. We can open the details of work and see who is the author, view these works on the website they were purchased, for example OpenSea, or we can also go to the assets view of this website and see it in and look at the collection in more traditional format. So this is all kinds of photography he buys. We can go and look at the individual items. This one is on foundation. We can view it there and see the details of work, for how much it was sold, and learn more about the author if we are interested. And the other virtual space of this collector is devoted to digital art, which is pretty cool also. And we can see that he has passion also for this kind of art. Okay, so I hope this shed some light on the personality behind the collectors that you might want to reach as well, to show, to sell, to promote your work.
Thanks for watching. Hope it was useful. I subscribe to my Instagram, because there in stories I also post a lot about popular NFT questions. Sometimes I have live sessions with artists who are interested in NFT. And if you like this video, hit like button and notification bell, and subscribe if you have not yet subscribed. And see you in the next video.